everybody, welcome back to another Amanda B episode. My name is Amanda, and if you are a new subscriber, thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for clicking on this video. You guys could tell by the title today. Today we're gonna be doing a quarantine cook with me. I'm gonna take you along when I cook. We're gonna sit down, eat, and we're gonna have a little girl talk, a little girl chat. If you guys follow me on Instagram, if you're not following me, make sure you go ahead, type in theoriginal.browning on your phone, on Instagram, go on my page, make sure you follow me and make sure you see what I've been posting, stay in tune with me. But if you guys follow me on Instagram, y'all know I be chefing it up, cooking it up this quarantine. I don't be cooking that much in my house, but I can cook, but I don't cook that much. But this quarantine, as I'm pretty sure everybody could relate, this quarantine has had me cooking like all the time. I'm gonna take you guys along with me in the kitchen. We're gonna cook a little, I guess, rasta pasta with chicken. That's what I'm gonna be making. What we're gonna be using is, I'm using the penne. Penny. I'll be like penny, or the penne, I think it's penne. But I'm gonna be using the penne noodles. Some boneless chicken breast, okay, yes. I'm gonna tell y'all what seasoning I'm gonna use later, cause to be honest, I don't really remember. I already went ahead and cut up the ingredients. I got some green peppers, red peppers, and some garlic. I don't have that much, as you guys could see, because it's just me and my mother. Pots that I'm gonna be using. Since I already cut up what I'm cutting up, I'm gonna go ahead and put the noodles to boil, and then I'm going to take my chicken out, cut it, and then just put it in a little bit of lemon juice and salt just to take out a little bit of rawness. Some people say, like, even though it come like this and there's no bones and stuff, they just take it out and cook it same way. I don't care if there's no blood on it, I still like to leave it in my lemon juice, get out the rawness and thing, because no, we don't do that here, baby girl. I'ma just let y'all watch me do what I'm doing, and yeah. taste this with you guys first. With hot tabasco. It tastes good though. Just a little bit of Parmesan.
Hours later.
Let's not focus it. I put on Instagram people to send in some girl talk questions. She said is screwed up relationships. I think a lot of girls, they'll get in a relationship, he cheated or whatever, like he just did some foul stuff. They've got their heart broken or, you know, whatever the guy may have done. They stay down and they stay in that mindset forever. Can't be crying over this guy forever. Mm-mm. Get back to what's important. You still got all these things you gotta get done. So you gotta pack up the feelings and let's go. You gotta get back up, baby. That is that, point blank, period. It's a wrong idea of healthiness. Everybody thinks being healthy is only like eating right and working out, like the physical stuff. But baby, that is not the only way to be healthy. Everybody thinks that's the only way you're supposed to be healthy. No. Everything that you do, you gotta do healthy. Healthy relationship. Number one, a healthy relationship with God. Number two, whatever comes after number two. If you have a boyfriend, if you have a spouse, whatever it is, your intimate relationships, whatever, you gotta be healthy too. Like, but even with friends, make sure you have the right people in your circle. The people that gonna motivate you, not the people that are gonna keep you stagnant or keep you down here. No, I don't believe you should be having any friendships where y'all can't help each other grow. Like if you have friends that not ambitious, not determined, they not trying to persevere, they're not trying to do nothing. Meanwhile, you in school, you working, you trying to do all this stuff for yourself. No.
Do me a favor, please. Get out of here. Get out of here, man.
If you have a friend that's not trying to up their life and better their life and up, that's them way. Someone said on my Instagram, supporting one's dreams plus passion. I spoke on this in my last talk. Watch that video if you never watched that video. Support is free. And I feel like if you're in my circle and you don't support, you're a hater. That's just how I'm gonna view it. I'm gonna view it as like you're being a hater, cause how we friends and I'm posting this and this every day or whenever I post it and then you never share it, but when Beyonce posts a new picture or Meg Thee Stallion is twerking, you're sharing it, you're quick to share every little thing these celebrities be doing, but you can't even support your own friend, your own family. Like, that's what's crazy to me. There's so much that black girls in my hood do. But like girls in Brooklyn be hating on each other for no reason. And like, why y'all can't comment on each other post? Somebody did some bomb lashes. Why you can't comment and be like, yo, you really did them lashes? Like, yes, girl, or something like that. Like, I'm not a hater. If I see a girl, we don't even gotta be close, but I follow you because I like how you do hair. I'ma comment and be like, yo, you slay that, sis. Or keep going, sis. Go, sis. I'ma say stuff like that. Or if somebody like, dang, why y'all can't? Why y'all trying? Why y'all haters? Like, why y'all always want to be haters? Like, come on. Let's unite. Let's encourage each other. Let's help each other grow. This is the end of my girl cooking with me and eating with me. And we having a little girl talk and chit chat. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. My camera...